fate of your world depends on it.
Now, we talked last time. I can't imagine anybody else in this role. I've heard all your co-stars say he is Shazam in real life, that kid trapped in a man's body.
Yeah. for better or for worse.
for better. Yeah. Are you any more of Shazam this time around, or the same amount of Shazam?
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. I'm just as much Shazam. I tried to age him up a little bit, right? The first movie, he was 14, 15. Now he's 17. And that's a pretty marked difference in a young boy's life, those few years. So I tried to, you know, age him up a little bit, give him a little more maturity, but also, you know, he's still finding his way. But aren't we all? I don't know. So I'm just trying to tap into whatever I know and I can relate to and whatever that character is. And and then I just get to have fun beyond that with this one because he's still a kid. And, like, when do you get hired to be an immature version of yourself other than things like this?
I'm an idiot.
You know, I love the scene, obviously, where who knew a superhero could also use a therapist at times and they come handy. And I thought to myself, you've been very vocal. Your book is fantastic, by the way. You've talked about the value of therapy. At any point did you think about casting your actual therapist in that
way? No. Although, actually, well, I've seen many therapists, so I would have had a myriad to choose from. The guy who played the pediatrician, not a therapist, he's a pediatrician I think is a therapist. He was wonderful, and you know, and you really want somebody who understands comedy and comic timing and all that. Which is not to say that there aren't therapists out there that aren't funny and don't understand comedy, but you know, we had a licensed professional actor, which was great.
Clip his wings, Anthea.
When you all see a movie like this for the first time without all the green screen and all this stuff, what is your reaction?
Oh, God.
Well, it's kind of the first time that you get to see the magic happen.
It's a lot of, oh, my God, that's what that looked like. I would have done that so different.
You trusted the director. Yeah, exactly. He's like, bigger, you know? And you're like, I don't know what I'm doing, but I'm just going to trust David. And also, David is not somebody who tells you to do something unless he really wants you to.
Right.
He kind of just trusts who he hires. And he lets them do whatever. Yeah. But then when it came to the blue screen and the dragon riding, and for you, like, I'm sure the wind, that
moment.
Even just my powers.
Yeah, exactly. He's like, just put your hands up, trust me. And I'm like, okay. And like,
she's like, do you want me to do more? He's like, no, just this.
No, perfect.
I want to start with a gift. I brought these last time. I don't know if I can trust you with them this early in the game, but these are the 2023 Harkins loyalty.
Hey, oh my god! Oh my gosh!
$2
refills. I'm gonna make so much milk out of this thing.
Last time you used him as a bullhorn.
It's like a conch.
It's like a...
All right, maybe this wasn't the best
idea. The best
idea.
Sorry.
And so I ask you to put them aside. Use them. Congratulations on this, you guys. I want to start out with the lair, because when we talked last time, I asked you what would be in your lair.
Mm.
You mentioned a koi pond.
Oh, I stand by
You mentioned a skate park.
I stand by that.
You mentioned a basketball
court. Completely different
things. Yes. I know what it would be in his now. But
Well, oh, I'm yeah. asking, with yeah. your success now, is anything in your lair that you dreamed of being in your lair years ago?
Yes. I think I've come up... Maybe I'd like a music room, a music studio, a little sitting... Did you think that I was going to say that?
Yes.
Maybe a spore garden with mycelium mushroom spores. I've been loving mycology. I'm getting really deep in mycology.
Are you watching The Last of Us?
No, I know.
Okay.
I know it's about fungus zombies and stuff.
Okay.
I did watch, what's that called? Fantastic Fungi.
Mm-hmm.
What was in my
Is there anything in your lair currently that, because of your success, you've been able to put in your lair?
Mmm. A couple new instruments.
Okay.
Little jewelry.
Nice.
What else?
You have a jewelry room, or is it just a jewelry table?
Just a table.
Okay.
I don't want to go too out.
It's a start.
Too full.
You're so humble.
You know, a little new clothes. Yeah. I don't know. You know.
Nice.
Something like, I'd say the instruments for the most part. It wasn't
We're getting more practical as we age,
it's
too.
Not
We're getting
as,
more practical, less outlandish. I'd like to see your lair. Invite me sometime.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I'd like to see yours, but you know.
How have you not seen each other? I mean, I know
Nashville,
you
Nashville.
I live in Nashville, Arizona.
That's tough.
Well, all over the grid.
I just threw a truck at a dragon. I love my life.